What you just saw is what you should be able to see while you're welding. You should be able to see the edges of the weld. You should be able to see the height or the crown. You should be able to see where your torch is, your filler wire. You should be able to see everything around your weld. A while back, we did a video for entry-level people getting into TIG welding. And one of the reoccurring questions was, I can't see, I can't visually acquire what I'm supposed to be looking at. Either it's not clear or for whatever reason, but it was a great comment and it came up several times. So today we want to address a couple of issues here that should help you in acquiring a clear vision of your weld pool. So one of the first things that we come across in this issue here of visual acuity is, you know, how long of a weld do I need to make and at what angle am I going to be looking at it? For comfort, I need to be out here at arm's length. It just makes sense to me because I'm comfortable and I'm able to move, okay? I've seen some people that they get right up here and get their face crammed up there, and I don't agree with that because of fumes and they always have to readjust their body. So let's talk about arm's length and being in a comfort zone here and being able to see and weld for distances comfortably. So the first thing is we need to find that focal point, okay? Whether you wear bifocal, trifocal, straight readers, no correction whatsoever, we've got to find clear focus at arm's length, whatever you use. So here's a perfect example of me gonna make a weld here, and I'm in a position that I'm comfortable with. My line of sight as I'm sitting here is right into this. I can see where I'm going the entire way. I'm comfortable. I'm at arm's length. Okay. Now, one thing I don't want to do is get up here if I'm forced into this position, because now I'm looking over the top of the cup. The cup is in my way. I don't want to lay down here. I mean, I could, but that's not comfortable to me. So again, I just want to get myself in some kind of position where I can see, I'm comfortable, and I can make this weld. I can actually see the edges of the plate, the edges of my weld, the weld crown, filler wire, cup. So from a vision and a comfort standpoint, this is what I'm very comfortable with. Again, I can see where I'm going, I can see what I'm doing. I'm at arm's length, I'm not in some weird position, I was able to move smooth. Another issue would be cover lenses. Cover lenses need to be kept clean. If you are one of these folks that like to roll your stuff around in the dirt and dust and get it all scratched up, you might be having a serious problem when you strike an arc. If you're looking through your hood and everything seems to be fairly clear and then you strike an arc and it's a bright blur, you're probably getting a reflection off all the scratches or off of all the things that have gotten on the plastic. So keeping your lenses clean, these plastic ones are replaceable, they're fairly inexpensive. Taking care of your hood is a big deal so that you can see. But if you have a bunch of scratches on your lens, this one has a fair amount right in the viewing area, you probably are getting a burst of light or a refraction of these scratches here. You can probably wipe them off once or twice, but each time you're wiping them off, you're scratching them. I've seen people that just, they get a paper towel and they go scratch the daylights out of it. I can assure you that that's a problem after a while. This one is perfectly clean. We just took the film off of it and it is like super bright. Keeping them that way is going to be hard. I don't ever lay my hood down where it's laying down toward the cover lens. I kind of set it off to the side where it's up. If I put it away of an evening, I might put a cloth over the top of it or put it in an area where it's not going to get sparks thrown on it or something like that. So that could be one of the issues, is keeping a clear cover lens. Let's talk about the shade of the lens, because that seems to be a big issue with some people. And again, this is This is kind of a personal thing because of how sensitive your eyes might be to the arc, okay? If I'm welding, and there are charts that reference where your lens should be as a general guideline. If you guys want access to the chart, look in the description below this video. So if I'm welding at real low amperage, and I'll say low amperage from 30 to 120 or something, I could probably get by with a number 9 shade. As soon as I start getting up above 150, 180, I should be interested in changing it to a 10. If I'm up above 200, 250, 300 amps, I would probably need to entertain thoughts of going to 12 and 14. Again, it is a personal preference. You know, when you're talking about the shade of a lens, a number 9, number 10, that's the higher the number, the darker the lens goes. You can try out different shades. You can try out different hoods before you buy them. You know, it's a big investment. Again, it's one of those personal pieces of gear that you use for welding every day. Your comfort, your visual acuity. Now, one more thing we can talk about as far as visual acuity. Let's talk about cheater lenses for a second. I use one every now and then. It is good for some close-up work. It allows me to see extremely fine detail. I don't like using them all the time, but they do make a good, valuable difference to me. So cheater lenses, again, it's one of those age thing versus how strong it is, and you can definitely go try those out. So we've talked about visual acuity, where to position yourself so you can see. We've talked about cover plates, darkness of filter lenses. I hope this helps. If we can help in any way, please get a hold of us in the comments. Thanks for your subscription to Weld.com. Check us out on Facebook and Instagram.
Those last two sounded the same.
No. Man Cubs is dull and empty. Mine is full of knowledge. It's high pitch. I hope you're recording that.
God dang it.